So I'm here today with Save the Ugly Animals. We want to see if anyone will give their hard-earned cash to save the blobfish, the naked mole rat, or this dog. Hello, sir. Would you like to save the ugly animals? Would you be interested in saving an ugly animal today? Would you be interested in saving an ugly animal? Did you know that 99% of all endangered animals are ugly? For example, this blobfish, pretty ugly. Naked mole rat, this dog. You don't want to save this dog?
No.
Thank you. Would you be interested in saving an ugly animal today? Would you like to save an ugly animal today? Look, if this brief experience is anything to go by, the job of a charity mugger or chugger is not for me. Harassing strangers to sign up to a cause they don't give a shit about for just $79.99 a month, you'd have to be mad or desperate. They hate it and we hate them.
Normally when I just try and walk around them, because you know, it's sort of inconvenient when they just want to talk and like get in a lengthy conversation.
I've either put my headphones in or I've just been looking down at my phone pretty much.
Like I just don't have the time or it's a charity that I don't care about.
This all might sound a bit harsh, but we've all done it. Put headphones in, pretended to be on a call. After all, we're all good people. We just don't have a lot of time. Excuse me, would you like to save
Fuck
the...
Off.
But it turns out chuggers aren't just getting shit from the public. They're also being ripped off big time by their employers, who, paradoxically, are charities. They're supposed to be the good guys. People like Oxfam, UNICEF, the Starlight Children's Foundation, and the Cancer Council are outsourcing their hiring to dodgy middleman companies who are underpaying workers to the tune of thousands of dollars.
The majority of the industry operates on a contractor or sham contractor model. What that means is you do not pay them an hourly rate of pay, you do not pay them superannuation, you do not pay work cover if they get injured. Worst case scenario, you do not get paid any money at all for the work that you do.
This comes after the middleman company Mondial were forced to pay up earlier this year. The Ombudsman found that since 2010, they've ripped off more than 800 employees of $770,000 in wages. But many more are getting away with it.
There are very few charities that aren't using this model now. We've been particularly engaging with a number of charities, including Oxfam, Greenpeace and Amnesty, around this issue. To date, they've been unwilling to enter into any form of arrangement.
But today, the Fair Work Ombudsman has announced a nationwide crackdown. The inquiry will select 15 charities at random to scrutinise, with a focus on the big earners and some middle and lower income charities as well. But according to the Fair Work Ombudsman, there are more than 54,000 registered charities in Australia, and many of them use these middlemen. So, really, it looks like the much maligned chuggers are actually in need of protection. In fact, they're a bit of a charity case themselves, really. The public needs to know.
Save the chuggers! Save me!
Do you know that charity workers like myself are not getting paid properly by the charities? Would you donate money towards me so that I get paid? But it's the only way I can get paid.
It's charity.
Oh, it's just me. I'm not getting paid.